everybody. It's My Two Tokens here, and we're reviewing Duke Nukem Forever. This is Bo.
This is Kyle.
And this is Ryan.
So this is our 4th of July review, so we decided to review Duke Nukem Forever. We're still trying to figure out who decided to schedule the worst game on the best day.
That'll be me.
You're not in this review. Shut up.
Yeah, quiet. So back to the review.
There's not really much of a story to talk about, though.
Well, give us the story that there is there. Since you're the expert on Duke Nukem in this group.
There is a man called Duke Nukem.
We're trying to keep this one short because the game literally blew chunks.
He really loves women, and they really love him too, okay? Saved the world about 14 years ago, back when the last game happened. In this game, the aliens come back, steal all his women, and Duke Nukem has to go save them again.
So that's the story.
That's it.
The aliens show up, they're pissed off at Duke, so they take all the women, and he goes, crap, now I gotta save the world again.
Yeah. No, he goes, crap, I gotta save the women again. He doesn't care about the world.
Yeah. That's a good point. Also, I want to point out, guys, I love how this game was so hyped, but it took 14 years to get out, and,
it blew.
It blew. It did. It kind of sucked. It really did. I mean, everyone bashes sequels of games, right, because they're never as good as the original, but this was one of those cases where 14 years of hype and a sequel just, it doesn't work, guys. It doesn't.
Not really.
What do you think of other things? Did the game look good? Ryan, what do you think?
The game looked like crap.
It did, in your opinion?
Yeah. See, they had boobs, but they were really badly done boobs.
I've seen better cartoon boobs from older games.
I have to agree the boobs were subpar, but is that really the point of the game?
You play Duke for the boobs, and if the boobs are bad, the rest of the game is bad.
Yeah.
That's
well,
true.
That and its awesome catchphrases.
Which weren't that awesome in this game, because they should have been left in the 90s.
Yeah. Alright, so what did you guys think of the weapons in the game?
Most of them, as far as I noticed, I didn't play through the whole game, so I didn't see every gun. But, I didn't notice any new guns.
That is true.
It did just look like it's the exact same guns reskinned.
It's just tacky. That's it. It's just, there's nothing new. It brought nothing new
to Duke Nukem.
Yeah. The other thing that everyone, because I have looked at other reviews, and I'm sure you guys have, the biggest negative to Duke Nukem is the fact that he now only holds two guns, because I played a few of the older ones. He has the ability to carry all the guns. Did he just lose the ability to carry a backpack in this one?
I way prefer to have all the guns all at once.
Oh, yeah, I agree too. That way you.
And here's the thing. It's Duke Nukem, he's supposed to be the most badass person on the earth, and he can only carry two guns at a time. Are you kidding me?
What's up with that?
What a pussy.
His health meter is his ego meter.
That I do love, though. I will say that was unbelievably creative. They didn't do the lame thing where he's got a health meter. It's his ego.
Which begs the question, Duke's ego, how can Duke's ego get any bigger, though? That's the problem.
Well, you know, I guess maybe winning high score in a pinball game? Who knows?
It's
an egotistical thing when you win a pinball game.
I'm just that more awesome.
They went and they said, look, let's make an R-rated game and let's push the envelope. And I feel that's all that Duke was. There's no substance to the game. And they just tried to push every envelope they could and didn't care about the game itself.
Yeah. One thing I do have to mention is that you can microwave a rat in and make it explode.
Can you hear the microwaves? I could never find the rat.
Well, yeah. Basically, you can microwave a rat and make it explode, and that's something cool, but
that doesn't make it go from a game to cool because of the fact
it
that
you
can microwave a rat.
But it's just one small thing that is interesting, but also it makes me want to put the rat man in the microwave. Okay. Everyone, listen. Rat man in a microwave.
I think it's funny, dude.
I don't either, but I'm trying to push the envelope.
It doesn't even work in this one.
I'm pushing an envelope.
It doesn't work!
Exactly.
Okay.
Because Duke didn't work either.
Since you guys have talked this entire time about what you hate about the game, what do you like about it?
Let's see, what did I like? I did like that they did try to update, you know, his catchphrases, so they did try to keep him relevant. I do appreciate that attempt. But it was failed, but I appreciated it.
Oh, there is one more detail, I guess, that I liked about the game. The loading screens give you useless tips.
Oh, that's always great.
Oh,
yeah, no, not useless tips as in, you know, they're actually being serious. In this, they were joking around saying, the shotgun does the most damage up close, which, you know, obviously everyone would know. They were joke tips, because everyone now in games they're putting in these stupid, useless tips for you, and you're like, why do I care? I already figured that out years ago.
That is one thing I didn't like about the game. Too many loading screens.
Yeah, but again, a lot of reviews have brought that up because it really was. in today's games, loading screens are there, but I didn't think there was going to be this many, and they are fairly long for a modern-day game.
Yes.
All right, guys, so I think we should do tokens. Ryan, how many tokens are you giving it?
What do you think? Zero.
Kyle?
I'll give it one, just because it's Duke.
You're giving it one just because it's Duke?
The nostalgia reasons.
We hate you.
And that's why you're our expert. Well, personally, I'm going to give it a half a token, and I know what you're saying. Wait, there's no half tokens on the list
here. We have half tokens now?
Apparently we do, because, you know,
I think you'll figure out what half a token is.
The game, honestly, was just god-awful and just annoying. So yes. I'm going to give it half, but it could honestly be maybe closer to zero.
All right, this is my two tokens review crew. I'm Kyle.
I'm Bo.
And I'm a DJ.
Apparently he's a DJ this week. Last week he was a cat, now he's a DJ. Also, guys, don't forget we're reviewing our video next week. It has to do with things that are red and a lot of guns. Oh, and before I get, guys, don't forget to vote on our new poll that we have up. It's the Tommy's Burgers poll. It's to see whether or not you guys agree or disagree with the fact that Tommy's Burgers should or shouldn't have
jail. Wait. What's Tommy's Burger?
You don't know what...
What the hell is wrong with you?
I've never been to a Tommy's Burger.
Tommy's Burgers is the most delectable burgers ever.
They have chili on their burgers.
Yeah, it's unbelievably delicious. The point of this poll is because Ryan and myself and Tyler went to go get Tommy's Burgers. I know what you're asking, why they serve a bunch of animals. We're not going to go there, okay? But we got the burgers and Tyler decided to get it without chili. And we thought this was inhuman.
This was atrocious.
It really was. So we've decided to ask our viewers what they think. And the way you guys vote is how Tyler will now eat Tommy's Burgers. We're just going to force you to eat chili.
Oh dear God, whatever will I do?
That's right. You will suck it up, Otter Boy. All right, guys. See you next time.
Well, this is a song for America. Home of the red, white, and blue. Land of Marilyn Monroe and James Dean. Apple pie, baseball, and Shell gasoline. And if you don't love her, f*** you.